We are back from Orlando. The Olympia was phenomenal. Really good weekend, really motivating seeing all of the hugest people in the world, the most jacked people in the world. But we're back to getting our usual kind of training in. So today's Monday and I'm doing my Sunday squats today. When it does come to traveling and when it does come to how you have your training weeks laid out, what I'll typically do if I am early on in the block, I will try to condense my training in to a calendar week so that all of my days or so that the next week's training cycle stays the exact same. So I like to have my training days go on a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday off, Sunday. However, if I'm early on a block and I have to travel and I have to disrupt my schedule, I will do a lot more days close together. So I don't mind doing 5 days in a row. However, the trade-off to that is you have less recovery. And as a result of less recovery, you may have to take weight off the bar in some sessions and you may just have subpar performances. Now, when I'm towards the end of a block like now, what I will typically do is I'll just extend the training week out, okay? So a training week does not necessarily need to run on the calendar basis, right? It doesn't need to run across 7 days, doesn't need to go Monday to Sunday. You can have it running longer than that. So that's what I did in this situation. So last week, because I was going to be traveling to the Olympia and having my training spread out and going to be having days which unforeseen circumstances popped up like I did. So say, for example, Wednesday didn't eat my first meal until 2 o'clock in the day because of just a number of unforeseen shit popping up in the early portion of the day. I trained after that. I did not necessarily train to the best of my capabilities when I trained on that day because of the fatigue from travel the night before. Again, we had a very late flight the night before, so I didn't have a great sleep, didn't have much food in me either when I was going to train. I was quite stressed about work. All of these things impacted my recovery. So if I was to condense my training into that calendar week and just try to aim to get my training done to keep my schedule the exact same this week, what could have essentially happened was that I would do this session on Saturday a day early, but as a result of doing it a day early, I would have had a subpar performance because I'm telling you now, on Saturday, I was fucking wrecked. The Olympia on Friday, pre-judging for open men's bodybuilding and all the female classes went on to like 12 o'clock, wasn't asleep until 1, and my body clock wakes me up at like 6:30 or 7, regardless of what time I got to bed. So if I performed this session on that day, I probably would have had a subpar performance. So it makes better sense from a recovery perspective to just space it out. And this is the exact same thing I recommend my clients do. If they're early on in the training cycle and they are traveling, try to fit in your training, or at least the most important training sessions within the early part of the week, or try to get them done so you can keep your schedule consistent the weeks going forward. But most people train on certain days because it fits your schedule the best. Now, if you are close to the end of a cycle and you have some heavy weights coming up and you know each session starts to affect the next one a little bit more differently, right? Early on in the training cycle, the weights are light, so you're less likely to have a lot of fatigue occurring from session 1 into session 2, into session 3, into session 4. However, as you start to get towards the end of the training cycle, session 1 starts to affect session 2 a little bit more because you have more to recover from. So it does make sense if you are getting towards the end of a training cycle to spread your days out a little bit more if you are going to be traveling, if you have something that's going to disrupt your usual training cycle, because you're going to have better recovery and you're going to have better performance. There is a trade-off to all those decisions, right? So if you condense your training, you have the benefit of keeping your following weeks the exact same in regards to what days you're doing each session. You have downside of not having good recovery. On the flip side, if you extend the training week, you have the benefit of better performance, better recovery, but you also may kind of disrupt your following few weeks of training. So these are things that you do have to think about. Now, most of the time anyway, we should be able to get in those first or initial training sessions because we should be trying to prioritize the hardest training sessions at the start of the week. And that's how you should be designing your training cycle. Because again, as you go towards the back end of a training block, or as you go through a training week, you're going to have fatigue accumulate from one session to the next. So it makes better sense to go from hard session, easy session, or not easy session, but moderately hard session, less intense session, because that's going to be a better way for you to have better performance, because you're going to feel best at the start of the week after a nice refresher weekend if you have the ability to just switch off the weekends, versus at the end of the week when you are maybe tired from work, tired from build up of other training and other stressors, and then as a result you could have poor performance. However, another thing that is worth considering is if you have a very stressful job, you have a high amount of workload on any given day, that's probably a day where you should not have your hardest training day. We'll be right back. Right, so I think we may have found my time to peak. We're gonna have two more sessions, unfortunately, that may go down like that. So that was the hardest session I've done this block. So pretty much all sets of squats there are like RP10. So I did four reps, didn't go for the fifth because the fifth one I definitely would have failed. So that was an overshoot. I did two reps on my first back off and then one rep on my third. So definitely fatigue is high. Could it be from the training? Could it be from the travel that I did the last few days? Potentially. And that's why we're going to have 2 weeks of down performances before we actually go into some kind of pivot cycle. So it's not necessarily going to be the funnest thing to do from my perspective. But, you know, if it helps us get better training information that will help me with better competition performance, then let's fucking do it. Bench was also down. That one was kind of a little bit annoying because the warm-ups felt okay, but it could, again, it could be travel fatigue, it could be fatigue for the block, it could be fatigue from the squats beforehand. So each exercise is going to affect the next, especially if you're hitting North P10. But again, better training information, and yeah, look, could just be a down week, and we'll see how it goes next week. So while there is all these like obvious things that could be impacting performance, the likes of the training fatigue, the travel fatigue, exercises affecting one another, another one that can't be overstated is like the expectancy effect. So the client today was talking to me about her own powerlifting prep at the moment and how she's getting in her head, and that little bit of self-doubt was stopping her from performing how she wanted. And that could be a case with myself today. Maybe I just wasn't hyped up for a session, which I wasn't really, and maybe I wasn't really expecting to hit the 227 for five. Maybe I wasn't expecting to hit the bench for five reps either. So all these things play into it. However, again, it's training, and these are just things to kind of pick up on in regards to your mentality, in regards to what is affecting each other, your training sequence, as I mentioned at the very start of the video. And it literally does all affect the next. There's so many factors that do affect the likes of RPE, rating of perceived exertion, as well as your training performance. So it's a good idea for you to be keeping track of these, whether it is using something like a logbook, taking notes at the bottom of that to say how you're feeling, recovery factors going into it, as I've mentioned in the last two videos, and that can all be better information for how you should approach following sessions and just continue to get better and refine your approach. Anyway, I'm gonna leave this video here, and I'll catch you in the next one. Hopefully next one is less of a down day and more of an up day.